Uh-oh. Black actor Denzel Washington is once again in hot water with the American laughter and its social warrior hacks in the media and on social media who just can't stand to hear the truth. Although Washington has always been known for his right-leaning views, this time the award-winning actor and director has really stepped in it by saying he believes that a strong family structure is a real cure for America's mass incarceration problem. Especially when it comes to the African-American community. The actor backed up his statement by saying that it all starts in the home. He later added that it's how you raise your kids, and if that kid doesn't have a father figure, as 78% of African-Americans don't, then that child doesn't have much of a chance of not ending up in prison during his lifetime. Via Blavity, underscore decorated actor and director Denzel Washington believes that a strong family structure is underscore the cure underscore for America's mass incarceration problem. Underscore, underscore while doing press for his latest film Roman J. Israel, Esquire, Washington was asked if his role as an activist lawyer changed his thinking about the prison industrial complex. Surprisingly, the acclaimed actor and Oscar winner had an interesting take. Underscore, underscore it starts at the home, he told the New York Daily News at the film's New York premiere. It starts at home. According to Washington, how a person was raised and whether or not a father figure had a prominent role in this family can influence a person's life choices. Underscore, underscore it starts with how you raise your children, Washington continued. If a young man doesn't have a father figure, he'll go find a father figure. It's unfortunate that we make such easy work for them. Underscore, mass incarceration is a huge problem in the United States that is seeing no end in sight. The leftist organization that is the ACLU has released estimates that currently there are 2.2 million people behind bars in the U.S. and the Equal Justice Initiative found that when you add into that number the number of people currently on probation or on parole, the number of Americans being watched by the justice system jumps to a whopping 7 million people. Most of which are minorities. Via Breitbart, 5 devastating facts about black-on-black crime. The mainstream American media is, again, happily hitting the Black Lives Matter crack pipe in its pernicious pursuit of high ratings. These bloodlusting junkies were nowhere to be found when, with haunting predictability, Chicago News headline after headline detailed the carnage that has consumed dozens of communities in that city where black men kill each other with terrifying regularity. Where were these Black Lives Matter protesters after the slaying of Chicago's little Tashaun Lee? The 9-year-old lured into an alley and shot to death by a black man seeking gang-related vengeance against his father. Did little Tashaun's murder at the hands of a black gangster, an all-too-common occurrence in Chicago, not warrant wall-to-wall news coverage or Al Sharpton and Jesse Jackson-style calls for justice? Number, why? Because the ugly truth behind #BlackLivesMatter is that black people killing other black people does nothing to advance its political power in the same way that one white cop killing a black criminal can. Despite the media's overindulgence on white cops killing blacks, there is still a far larger amount of black bodies being sent to morgues by black killers. Here's 5 devastating facts, liberals can't deny, that prove it. Fact 1. Over 1,400 more black Americans murdered other blacks in 2 years than were lynched from 1882 to 1968. According to FBI data, 4,906 black people murdered other blacks in 2010 and 2011. That is 1,460 more black Americans killed by other blacks in 2 years than were lynched from 1882 to 1968, according to the Tuskegee Institute. Fact 2. Black people, mostly men, commit a grossly disproportionate amount of crime. In 2012, white males were 38% of the population and committed 4,582 murders. That same year, black males were just 6.6% of the population but committed a staggering 5,531 murders. In other words, black people at just a fifth of the size committed almost 1,000 more murders than their white counterparts. The figures above highlight a horrific truth that black racialists and white liberals routinely ignore: law-breaking black Americans, young black males particularly, put themselves in close proximity to, mostly white male, police officers at rates sometimes 5 to 10 times higher than whites. This is a recipe for disaster. Thusly. Fact 3. Despite making up just 13% of the population, blacks committed half of homicides in the United States for nearly 30 years. Dodge statistics show that between 1980 and 2008, black people committed 52% of homicides. In 2013, black criminals committed 38% of the murders. Whites accounted for just 31%. There are 5 times fewer black people than white people in America and, yet, they consistently carry out the larger share of the crimes. Given this rate, it's no wonder that there aren't more instances where cops kill black criminals. Fact 4. Chicago's death toll is almost equal to that of both wars in Iraq and Afghanistan, combined. There have been almost as many deaths in one American city as there have been in the 2 major wars carried out by the U.S. military this century. Chicago's death toll from 2001 November 26, 2015 stands at 7,401. The combined total deaths during Operation Iraqi Freedom, 2003 to 2015, 4,815, and Operation Enduring Freedom, Afghanistan, 2001 to 2015, 3,506, total 8,321. Fact 5. It would take cops 40 years to kill as many black men as have died at the hands of others black men in 2012 alone. University of Toledo criminologist Dr. Richard R. Johnson examined the latest crime data from the FBI's Supplementary Homicide Reports and Centers for Disease Control and found that an average of 4,472 black men were killed by other black men annually between January 1, 2009, and December 31, 2012. Professor Johnson's research further concluded that 112 black men died from both justified and unjustified police-involved killings annually during this same period. There have been multiple studies as to why so many people are in the justice system in the U.S. The most sound theory statisticians have been able to come up with has indeed been the fact that when you don't have a father figure in the home as a child, your chances of going to prison later in life jumps astronomically. But sadly, since President Lyndon Johnson and his Democrat Party turned African Americans into the kept class in order to secure their votes, there is no end in sight. Please share if you support Denzel Washington. Follow us on Facebook at Freedom Daily.